Hi, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today it's raspberry day. Who knew? All of a sudden I came out here to look for cucumbers and tomatoes, and what do I see? All of the raspberries are suddenly ripe. I didn't even know we had this many this year. Our garden that's over on the other side of the yard was decimated last year in the drought. These guys weren't, for whatever reason, and these are producing prolifically. So we had to pick them tonight because they're ready. They're falling on the ground ready. So.
And I would guess, just looking at what I can see, you're going to probably have at least twice the amount you picked already, if not more.
Probably.
Amazing.
And the Japanese beetles are here, but you can see evidence of them on the leaves, but they aren't as bad as they have been in seasons past, which is a good thing.
Now, are you picking or eating?
I am picking.
Oh, okay.
Every now and again, I have to taste, though, to make sure that they're ready. And I find some that are not, but pretty much beautiful raspberries.
Okay, well, let me put the camera down and give you a helping hand.
Please do. Well, I'd say that is a pretty, pretty good display for our first picking. And we've had one or two before, but this is our best so far.
And what are you going to do with all these now that you've got them picked?
Well, I may give a few away, share them, and then we'll eat some fresh and some we will freeze. So there's two ways to freeze. You can just lay them out on a cookie sheet and freeze them so they are singular, and you can just pour them when they're frozen into a bag. Or better yet, I like to mash them up just a little bit and add a sweetener to them and then freeze them.
Well, let's take them in, and are you going to do that tonight?
I don't know. You can't wait too long.
Well, maybe we better do it tonight and get it in. Get it in the freezer.
Could be. Now that we brought them in from outside, I figured we had about 9 pints of raspberries. Gave one away, and this is what we ended up with. So this is how 9 pints of raspberries look. These were not quite ready. This was my compost pile of ones that I didn't want, bruised, diseased, whatever, overdone. Went through berry by berry, as I always do, to make sure that what we're eating is actually berries. Many people buy raspberries at the store. When you pick your own raspberries, you have to do something with them right away. Unlike the ones you buy in the store, which can sit on your counter, sit in your refrigerator for days, and they do not seem to get overly ripe too fast. They taste pretty good, but you just wonder, when did they pick those that they can last so long?
And what did they do to them?
What seeds did they grow them from? It's just a question. These we picked less than an hour ago. I mean, some of them are mushy already. So you can tell that when they're fresh from your garden, you know where they came from. You know how good they are. You know that you didn't put anything bad in them or in their soil.
And you know they're not probably GMO either.
No, probably not. Because I believe these were here when we moved into this place.
We were grandfathered in 35 years ago.
Yeah, they've been around a long time. I have enough jam in our reserves. I don't want to make this into jam. So I am just going to slightly mush them because a lot of them are already very ripe. And that's another thing. When they're ripe and you're picking them, they fall, literally fall off the vine. So again, I say, I don't know how the store people can possibly have raspberries that are so perfect. These are ones that aren't quite ready. They will probably be way too ready tomorrow. But I just thought it'd be fun to have some fresh that I don't have to go out and pick them tomorrow. So this is about all I do. I don't mess with it too much. Then I am going to be putting some sugar in there. You could use stevia. You could use honey. You could use agave. All those different kinds of sweeteners. I prefer to just use my regular old sugar for the time being.
You mean you don't want plastic sugar in your food?
No. I'm going to put that much in, and then I'm going to taste it. Let me get my spoon. And this is all personal preference. So this is probably half of them that are in here right now.
I can already see where this would be delicious over ice cream.
It would be
pancakes.
Delicious. Yes. In pancakes. You can make muffins out of them.
Now, do some people have problem with the seeds?
Some people do.
Diverticulitis.
Some people do, and that's why you can buy a jam in the store that doesn't have the seeds in. Mm-hmm. You could squeeze them out. You could put them in.
Strain them?
Strain them by running them through a food processor. That won't actually break up the seeds, but then you could squeeze it through a bag or put it through a sieve. It's a lot of work.
A muslin bag? Cotton?
What do you call that stuff? Cheesecloth.
Cheesecloth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That. Okay, that's perfect. So.
Notice how she gets to taste it and I don't.
You're busy. Mm-hmm. This isn't going to give us a whole lot. I think I've washed far too many containers, but that's okay.
Now I notice you don't always fill them up to the top too, especially when you're freezing.
Right.
You want to give room for expansion?
Exactly. So that's about it. And that's a nice portion for one meal if you were going to have it as a fruit sauce, or if you were going to make something out of it later. It's handy. So if I get four of these pints out of this many berries, that's probably going to be it.
So while you picked nine pints,
right,
you're going to end up with four pints.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Could have a little bit more in, so that'll have to be for the next batch. Did you want to taste this one?
Should I be so lucky? What if it's not sweet enough for my taste?
Well, that's what you're tasting it for. You have to get your own spoon, though, because we won't mix our spoons. I'm going to say this needs a little bit more sugar, but then we'll see. See what you say. Here, I'll let you have a little more than I did.
Not bad. I don't know.
Okay. I guess if it's good enough for you, then probably enough. Well, from 8 pints of berries, we ended up with 4 pints of raspberry sauce. So that tells you half of what was in that each container was air in between, or the few things I took out. So give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, if you learned something. Thank you so much for watching, and we'd love to hear from you.
Now, do you really think those are going to make it downstairs into the freezer?
Well, most of them will. I might let you keep this one up here for your ice cream.
Oh. So, fringe benefits, huh?
Yes. Well, you did help pick.
I did. Okay.
Clean up.